This is where it gets really pretty and interesting, is when we get down into Colorado, see the mountains, kind of go through the edges of the mountains here, down to Albuquerque. So we're going to go through Las Vegas, New Mexico, Raton Pass.
Who's excited for the train?
I am!
Y'all ready?
Well, I always find it interesting how when you do a trip like this, particularly when you can take the train like we're doing.
1 hour and 40 minutes to our next station south, Las Vegas, New Mexico.
People sort of just gravitate back here to the observation car. People get to meet each other, know each other over the next several hours, sometimes into the middle of the night. And by the time we actually get to Albuquerque, people will actually have sort of gotten to know each other a bit, and we won't be going in there as individuals now. We'll be going in there as a group that where people know each other and already have formed some friendships, which is great for me. I like that. I like the train for that reason. Not only does it get all you to see the countryside and experience this old-time way of traveling, but it really gives people time to meet each other and get to know each other. So I think that's a good part of this. Well, there is myself and one other faculty member on this trip, and then we have four women and six men on the trip. So we have a total of 10 students who are on this trip from a number of disciplines, from the arts, from mass communications, all over the place. So, which is kind of fun. Instead of just having one discipline, we have various disciplines, so people who might not normally get to meet each other on campus actually get to do that on the trip.
You're probably going to sleep the whole way there, the two blocks.
No.
Part of 66. That's why he did this. This is Route 66.
Yeah.
A little tiny
66.
A little tiny piece of it.
On Sunday, we'll be driving over to Tucumcari, New Mexico, but along the way we're going to stop near Mountaineer at Salinas National Monument for people to see historic Native American settlement with the ruins of an old Spanish church.
Everybody, to Quarai, part of Salinas Pueblo Missions National Monument. Prior to Europeans arriving here, there were 11 Indian Pueblos along this side of the Manzano Mountains. In the 1600s, seven of them ended up with mission churches in the first few decades after New Mexico became a kingdom of New Spain. They were dry land farmers, and in the 1670s there was a devastating drought. All of the villages ran out of food and had to be abandoned. And now, all these centuries later, there are three that have something left that you can see, and that's this national monument. And of the three missions in this national monument, this is the tallest and most intact. This model depicts a pretty good impression of what the Pueblo probably looked like in the middle 1600s.
What I like to see students get from this trip, and what it's my experience they do get from this trip, is usually, first of all, I think students that take it, go on this trip, have a sense of adventure about them.
There's Pueblo women that laid these stones. Men didn't mind cutting down trees and carrying logs and shaping wood and doing what we think of as carpentry work, but mud and rocks, that's girls' work.
They really do want to be open to other cultures, other experiences. And when they do this, they come away with maybe a whole different view of a part of the country they knew very little about, cultures that they might not know a lot about. Where we're going is there's a lot of cowboy culture, there's a lot of Hispanic culture. Later afternoon to Tucumcari, where we'll finish out the day with a barbecue out at one of the Friends of the Museum ranches in Tucumcari.
To be honest, I didn't know what to really expect out of this trip besides a good time. You know, it was something different, you know, but when I got out here, I realized how awesome it really is out here. The view, the people, the whole experience is just wonderful, you know, and I didn't know what to expect. I really didn't. You know, I've been down to Mexico a few times, but this is different. And it's right here in home.
I'm Gretchen Gerkler. I'm the director of the Dinosaur Museum and Natural Sciences Laboratory in Tucumcari, New Mexico, on old Route 66. The interesting thing with Cuevo is, you know, you wonder why a town like that went out. I mean, why do we see ghost towns throughout the Southwest? And a lot of it has to do with water. What we had in the area is, used to have steam engines, and every 25 miles, they had to stop for water. And both of those towns are now ghost towns, but they used to be stops for the railroad to be able to get a new supply of water. That's the reason for so many ghost towns, because you look at it and you say, well, there is water here, and there's a railroad. Why did this community go under? Well, it has to do with the changes in the steam.
Too many cameras. Rock Valley College.
In what town?
Rockford.
Okay, I've heard of Chicago.
It's actually not far from Wisconsin, right?
Yeah.
25 miles from Wisconsin.
We went to a lady's house. Her name was Karen Kelling, and she owns a lot of land. We went inside, and then I stepped outside for a bit, like, without anyone else, and it was just so open and quiet, and I was just like, man, this is so cool. Like, I'm really glad that I came down for this trip, because these are really cool experiences that I'm having.
The rule of thumb here is you can have one cow-calf pair per inch of rain per section. So if it has rained 14 inches, you can have 14 head of cows in a square mile. So that's why the ranches have to be really big.
She made us cookies, and she was so nice and sweet, and she showed us this really cool bottle, and like I had to get like a, I took like a piece of paper and a pen, and I got the image off of it, and I still have it, and it's really cool. And then we went and had lunch down at like the homestead.
Let's see how fast you can go around that, Mike.
Not faster than this.
Come on, go on the inside rim, you'll be fine. And if you fall, you'll just fall into that pit.
Oh yeah, except I'm taller than this, so my head will bash the other side.
It's impossible to predict the future.
Right now, we are working on the prep work. We are pretty much just cleaning off Concus Man. We're cleaning off bird poop and stuff like that. Some people are washing windows.
Still looking dirty.
Earlier, we brought up some rocks so that we could fix the walls. Pretty much mostly what we've done. Some people are doing the electric work now.
Just finishing it up. Almost done. Feels good. I like electrical. Internship. Somebody.
What's been your favorite part?
Oh, okay. Working with others. You know. Mm-hmm. Proud of myself. Thank you.
Did you like the bluegrass last night?
Yes, loved that.
Yeah?
Yes.
What did you like about it?
Yeah, the music was so inspiring, you know, touched my very creative mind. So peaceful. Yeah, I think they are great people.
That bluegrass was just amazing. Oh, man. Wonderful people. Real nice. They were being at the church and listening to that music was just amazing. I loved it. Really did.
And what's been your favorite part of the trip so far?
Interacting with the other students from Rock Valley that, you know, I know Jalen, but I didn't really much know of anybody else, you know, so I guess just meeting new friends and meeting friends out here in New Mexico and just getting to know everybody is, I would say, would be the best part of it all.
We're just cleaning the paintings that were hanging in the building, and quite frankly, I don't know how long they've been hanging. I think he donated them in 2005, and there was some splatter from paint when they did the ceiling, and the Corps of Engineers and the conservators were worried that the paintings were ruined. But I think to our great relief, it really is coming off a whole lot easier, and we just took soft cloths and a little bit of water and now using some elbow grease, and we can already see that, I would say with close to 90%, it was just dirt sitting on the top.
We're the cleaning crew.
We went to the Mesa Lands Community College today, and we had the curator give us a tour of his lab, and he showed us all like what they're working on right now and what the students are working on for their projects, and it was really cool. Like, you could see like pieces that they had put back together, and like the pieces that they hadn't found the proper place for. Sometimes they'll get a donation, but other times they'll have to like go out into the field and get it, and when they do that, they have to like just bring up like a big rock.
Yeah. It shattered into numerous pieces. Yeah, some of them I've glued together, those I got stuck, and these two chunks here were glued back because there's some pieces still sticking in it, so this needs now to be prepped away.
After they're done, they have to take like these tools that they're kind of like a Dremel, and they like have to be really careful and like grind all of the red iron-y stuff off. Tunnel thing, that was really cool. We went under the dam and like we had to go through this big tunnel, and like there were two giant tubes that went all the way through on either side, and there was like a catwalk in the middle, and all the grates would like clang around and make a really loud sound. But it was so cool. It was dark and it was kind of damp in there. I don't know, it was like kind of daunting almost. Like, you're just like, wow, there's all this water here. It's just so much stuff. It amazes me, like, how they built that. We were in there because we had to go get scaffolding and so we could work on the conscious man's house.
Me and Don were working on making a substance to fill in the graffiti on Conscious Man. And we made it out of some rock dust. We grinded some rocks in the dust, mixed it with a little water to make it into a paste.
I feel like I'm in a reality TV show.
And if you would.
Yeah. Did you see like the
cameras
video?
Everywhere.
Yeah, it creeps me out now. You see like the lady when you're
you're thinking of the good old days, like a dream I had and want to have again. My soul was free in the land of enchantment and wood stoves and juniper trees. A distant view, far as I could see, of teepees and hot springs and pictures by Georgia O'Keeffe.
Fall and die. Mexico, but we'll be getting it from two angles.
Oh yeah. Oh, oh yeah. I said new, 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 new. Mexico. Oh yeah. Oh, oh. Time passes and years bring change.
What's good? That's my game, man.
So Lynn, what are we doing here?
We're just waiting for the last thing.
Well, no, what are we waiting for? How come we're not in the air right now?
Because our plane had to deplane because they couldn't get the paperwork together because somebody didn't follow the process and it's broken. And so we have to stay one more day.
Yay, Albuquerque.
Yes.
I wonder what his blood pressure is right now. What do you think,
it could be?
How's your blood pressure? All that Zen time in Mexico for those years.
Oh.
My fault?
Yeah, you said I don't want to go home.
Okay.
Remember?
I'm taking away from all
this.
We have that old record somewhere, I'm sure.
So why are we here? Why aren't we in the air?
Can I swear?
Sure.
Because some head had no clue how to do some damn documentation or to do a scheduled check on the plane. So now we're stuck here because of some dumb.
This is the plane that did not take us home.
Memories remain. Yes, they do.
That, no.
Oh, boy. Oh, man, the wind's coming from that way.